One.
Let's just look at Judd playing with the rest here. As I say, looks a little bit ungamely. Not as free flowing an action as he has when he plays a normal shot. And
Judd from one, thank you.
That was unexpected.
Yeah, ungainly or not, he doesn't miss many with the rest. Certainly not slow drops like that.
Yeah, it's not a criticism that, as I say, it's just simply because he plays with the other hand. There's quite a few left-handed players play right-handed with the rest. Barry Hawkins is another. Why is it, Clive, that you don't get any right-handed players that play left-handed with the rest?
I pass on that one, Alan. With pink hanging over the pocket, there's obviously a possibility of the reds gradually encircling it. And ultimately forcing a re-rack.
Not the sort of frame you'd associate with Judd and Ronnie's matches, but sometimes the balls dictate things that you just can't avoid. Anyway, Judd has the upper hand in it. Yeah, Ronnie may not even be interested in laying on the red near the cushion. He may have to just come off cushion first and play the loose red. Hope it goes safe. Yeah, that's quite clever, but he's going to be in trouble again. As long as Judd can avoid the blue here, he should get Ronnie in a bit of strife.
Pink's right on the edge now. O'Sullivan saw a chance to break the pattern there. Not everyone would have done.
Yeah, it was risk attached to it, wasn't it? But this is a chance for Judd. It's not difficult to cover the red that's on the pink spot. He's just worried he's just overhit it. That's maybe given Ronnie a chance to get the upper hand that Judd's held for, well, the last 8 or 10 shots. He's got it.
It's an unusual sort of frame for O'Sullivan, but he's enjoying it.
Daniel Sullivan, 4.
I thought that might be a go again somehow.
I think the crowd are enjoying this as well. It'd be a shame if Olivier Martil gave the players the 3 shots each. This is really unusual, but very enjoyable. Ah, oh, good shot.
Yes, played it cushion first.
Just laughing at Ronnie there. Now they're having a laugh.
Snookered.
Short playing it first time, and I wouldn't blame him. There you go. Just a
foul,
little practice shot.
Run your 7-4. Yeah.
This little duel has been in progress 7 minutes.
Cushion first. Well, I suppose he can do off the side cushion. I don't know if he'll look at that, but side cushion just missed the black. He should be alright. You wouldn't fancy him potting the pink playing that shot, but he's playing it the other way, dead weight. This is dangerous.
Just let's say somebody pots a red in a colour. How does he get on his next red? It looks as if this particular duel is going to be fought to the death. The referee, if he could see no sign of progress, could say 3 more shots each, 4 more shots each, but no cause to do that yet.
He Yes, Olivier would have to wait until the time comes when it's an absolute stalemate, but there's always really someone who's got some kind of advantage.
So it's O'Sullivan who makes the mistake in the end. So that little jolt took 11 minutes. In addition, Trump was left to plant. So this is a chance for Trump to take a 2-1 lead.
Five.
And it becomes a even bigger frame, I think, than it felt like before for both players here with that 11 minute safety jolt. That would have expended quite a bit of energy and effort from both players, so whoever wins it will be delighted to the other guy to see all that effort.
12.
No reward. Will it be O'Sullivan?
Tried to move the 13. Other red and black.
Now, I don't think Judd should be snookering Ronnie here. I think he should be resting the cue ball on the left side cushion in bulk. If he snookers him, O'Sullivan can then come off the side cushion, try and rest on the red.
Ground ball. Judd Trump.
Yeah,
13.
That's clever as well. He's putting the brown down there to stop that escape. And this is good for Judd, I think, Ronnie playing this. Every chance of leaving something. The way Ronnie's playing that. But it's a good result. It just surprised me that Judd didn't play the yellow off the red and leave the white near the yellow pocket. That would have made that escape much more difficult. As he left it just above the middle pocket, O'Sullivan could control the swerve. I just missed a trick there, I feel, Judd.
And to snooker. O'Sullivan's got the red safe though. Bit of good running that for him.
Looking at the black here, O'Sullivan, he may be just trying to chip the red just onto the black or above it. Oh, that is a brilliant shot. Quite deliberate, that.
Foul and a miss. Free ball.
Just got the cue ball slightly too far into the jaw of the pocket. O'Sullivan can't hit both edges of the red, so that gives him a free ball and freedom to nominate any colour as an extra red.
Yeah, he may as well play the yellow. He's not going to tie it up any, unless he were to double kiss it, and I don't think he would. Deciding on the blue because the natural angle half ball isn't going in off in the yellow pocket. Decided to play it with stun just to take that out of the equation. But he's pretty much left Judd the same shot he had a few seconds ago. Of course, if there was any little drift in the table, he's then learned from it. Oh, it's
foul. And a miss, Ronnie O'Sullivan, 7.
Misses it the other side this time.
Another free ball then.
Blue ball.
An 11-minute safety duel. Another duel in progress on the last red. You won't see many half-hour frames between these two.
This is a pretty easy basic chance of a snooker if you can just push the red into the middle of the table. Looking at going in and out of bulk to try and hit this red. I think he can get this off one cushion. He'd have to get the butt in the air though. Play it with a lot of screw and it would just bend the cue ball and arc it back into the red. Obviously he sees it better down there, but it looks on to me.
O'Sullivan, 7, free ball.
Another 7, another free ball. Still can't hit both edges of the last red. Instead, O'Sullivan exercises one of the other options he had, which was to have the balls replaced in their original positions, because this is a really vile snooker to get out of.
My opinion is a miss.
Yeah, Judd is just querying Olivier there about the decision to award O'Sullivan the miss.
Ronnie?
Nothing untoward in it. He just feels that this is his only method of escape. Oh, that's well done. Good hit. Deserves to get it safe. And he has.
Very good. Wanted to move the red as little as possible. Sullivan thought there might be a chance if he could make a full ball cannon on the brown that he would leave Trump snookered yet again. Potting attempt from Trump, but it was always taking the cue ball to the ball cushion.
Taking this on for sure, Judd. Safety's every bit as hard as the pot. And the brown's obviously in waiting there. Can't fail to land on it should he pot this.
Sullivan attempted a very difficult cut back there. Knew there was a chance of snookering Trump behind the green if he missed it, but he wasn't certain to. So is this where O'Sullivan can change gear and win the frame?
Yeah, what a great shot that was. To get an angle on the black was a bonus as well, but what it does mean is he now doesn't need the
eight.
Blue, O'Sullivan. He's just checked the scoreboard, he's 10 in front as we can see. So up to and including the brown.
Trump going to be saved by the pink?
13.
He is not. To go 19 in front with only 18 left.
Ronnie O'Sullivan, 17.
So Trump needs a snooker. A chance for O'Sullivan to end the frame.
Thank you.
Trump decides to
five.
Pot the blue and put all his eggs in one basket with only one potential snookering ball.
It's often said that
Chatram,
when
five.
The player pots the blue and leaves pink and black in the tail and needs a snooker, people say, oh, he only gets one chance, but not if you're clever. Keep that pinks, you know, safe enough times, you'll get plenty of chances. This isn't a great chance, but you can play it thin, get the pink in the bulk cushion, an outside chance of getting in behind the black. If he doesn't get it this time, he'll probably get another shot at it.
O'Sullivan leaving plenty of distance between cue ball and object ball. Rule one for Trump in this situation is to make sure that he doesn't leave the pink on.
Foul. Ronnie O'Sullivan, six.
Frank, well, maybe that should be rule two. O'Sullivan. Rule one is don't miss the pink altogether attempting a thin contact and leave yourself needing two snookers. So, the end of a 41-minute frame.